As an organization for content space, we came into Africa around 3 years back, though we have been working in Africa for the last 10 years. And when we came here, what we saw was the service penetration levels for content and entertainment services were pretty low. And the content industry was quite fragmented. The IP protection, the copyright protections were not really available for the artists. And so what we did, we started working with various music associations in different countries. Today we have our operations from content perspective in 18 different countries. And what we do is we work with local artists, labels, content aggregators, and the music associations in different countries. And we ensure that the copyrights of the rightful owners are protected and they are rightfully compensated for what they own. And keeping that in mind, what we when we started off in Africa 3 years back, the service penetration levels were around 5%, and today we see penetration levels from 20% to 40% in different countries. And around 3 years back, what we also saw was that the content consumption was pretty low, and people were, the artists and the labels were not really very comfortable in providing that content because of the piracy and copyright violations. And today what we see is the whole scenario has changed dramatically. And today we have been able to see 10-20-fold increase in content consumption. Going forward, what I see is, as you see, the smartphone penetration in Africa is increasing significantly. It's going at a very rapid pace, as well as the mobile broadband consumption is also doubling every two to three years. But still there's a large percentage of people who will still own feature phones. So any solution which has to be there has to keep in mind the feature phone population as well as the smartphone population. So it should cater to people who are conversant with tech services or voice services as well as rich media services around video. And what we have seen is when we provide relevant content to people, people are really interested in consuming that content. We had run a pilot in one of the countries where we provided personalized and recommended services, and what we saw was people who were on personalized services were consuming 48% more content than people who are not on personalized services. And that actually proved that if you are really able to provide relevant services, relevant content to people, they are likely to consume it, because that makes it that much more easy for them to consume that content. Content industry is very localized in nature. It has extreme local flavor, and somebody from outside cannot really do justice to it. I can't, sitting in India, can say, okay, I understand what people like in DRC or a Chad or a Nigeria. So you have to have the local understanding, and for that having local talent is extremely important. As an organization, 3 years back we decided to invest heavily, and we made it a point that we'll hire local talent. So today we have around 200 people in Africa. Out of that, 90% are actually local people, and that also helps us in kind of understanding local market much better, local cultures much better, and also establish relationships in a much more trustworthy way, because somebody sitting 5,000 miles away, you really can't develop that kind of a trust unless you have somebody who is locally present and understands that local market. So it's very, very important to have local understanding and local people who help grow the business and provide the right services. What we see is, one, music is extremely in demand. It's a music-loving continent. In fact, I'll give you an interesting example. In one of the countries, in DRC, when we started, we had estimated that service penetration levels will probably touch 10% or so from 5%. And within 3 months, we had seen that level grow up to 30%. It was really interesting to see. I'd never seen anything like that before. So what that actually proved was, if you have the right content available with you, people really want to consume it. And they're interested in consuming that content if it is something which is of interest to them. Going forward, what I believe, we also need to look at how do we provide more relevant services to people. In that terms, be it educational services over mobile, because mobile penetration levels are much higher than any other medium. Be it healthcare services, I believe these are the two kind of areas which are going to be very important and very interesting going forward. In addition to that, I think there's another piece which is coming in, which is around mobile governance. So where companies like us have started looking at some of those initiatives, we are trying to see if we can work with the governments in different countries to be able to provide governance initiatives which governments have in different countries to be able to take these to the people there.